I'm usually more graceful. It's just not one of those days. Any kind of recognition, I was just like, wow, I want to do more of this.
Bas 2 minutes. Chalna bhaiya, 2 minutes. Ho jayega. Chalo, chalo. I'm sure you're used to getting.
No, no, it's fine, yeah.
Yeah.
This security is a sadhu. He's not letting us sit here.
We'll find
just
another.
Keeping it on camera. In case you want to use this. The reality of our time.
Ja rahe bhaiya, thank you though. You know, Sobhita, this is great, and I love that we're walking and talking.
Dressed alike.
It's a dressed
look alike. Sisters from hell.
But first things first, I want to get it out of the way. Why are we walking on a random street in Bandra in the middle of the afternoon?
I love walking. I take my phone and my earphones, get something to drink, and I keep walking in random streets. I don't open Google Maps. I don't necessarily go to parks alone. I just keep walking. People watching. It's like training for my acting.
Really? You just take off on long walks?
Yeah.
And
anywhere. Any place I travel to also.
Oh, so all over the world you
I just like, because I feel like it is in those unknown or unshared places that you see the most local vibe, you know?
Yeah. But I'm actually curious to know, are you still able to do this? Like post Made in Heaven, are you still able to take these random walks in these random streets?
I went to this cafe to pick up some coffee and someone was like, are you the lady from heaven? And I'm like, yes, I am.
The lady from
the
heaven.
The lady from heaven. I feel dead, but okay.
So you get stopped. What's it like?
Mostly I just wish like, yaar, I wish I did some makeup. Because they're going to be like, nahi, she was nice in the show, but real mein theek hai.
Come on. You know, I've seen these memes on the internet where apparently if you search for goddess on Wikipedia, guess whose face pops
up?
Yeah, that really? Is some serious praise. So how are you assimilating all of this?
I would like my mother to see this. Who thinks I'm a wreck?
Really? So,
they haven't watched it yet. I don't know what's wrong with them.
Your parents haven't watched Made in Heaven?
My parents are throwing shade at me.
Wow, why haven't they?
I mean, initially the Wi-Fi was down.
Okay.
And then, I think my father's just busy. And my mother saw the 9th episode first and she's confused. I'm like, obviously. And they don't speak Hindi. So I'm like, you know what, just don't bother. Yeah, it's fine. When you come, like when they come to Bombay or when I go to my hometown, Vizag, I'll sit down and show it to them, like homework.
I want to talk a little bit about Vizag. Because here's a girl from Vizag who just upped and left and decided she wanted to be in the so-called city of dreams. You know, all of us have these crazy Bombay stories because I came here to work as well. So, you know, finding that little house or going through brokers. What was your experience like just setting up shop in a new city? Because I don't know if I've heard of another girl from Vishakhapatnam who's like, mujhe Mumbai jana hai types.
I'm sure there are girls from like other states, other cities, of course. My hometown, I haven't met, I don't know.
The star of Vizag.
Hair flip. I finished my 12th standard and I took part in something called Miss Vizag. Which is, so my mother was, we were at some, it was like a lifestyle exhibition where they sell sofas and furniture and just random shit, yeah. So she went there and they were distributing these pamphlets and they were like, we're looking for some tall girls to take part. And
Tall girls.
And
check.
And my mom was like, oh, it's a personality contest. I think you will improve. Go. And I took part and I won. And I realized for the first time, that was my first taste of attention. Of any kind. I was a kid. I was 15 or something. 16 or whatever.
Hmm.
And there was no concept of beauty. It was super nerdy, super geeky, super uncool kid who's like this first bencher, lame.
Who is now goddess on Wikipedia, mind you.
Please note. Crushes in school who didn't give me any attention.
Eat shit. Let's go here.
Oh, nice. Miss Vizag, I took part. I won my first taste of attention for this really uncool kid with like little to no friends who spent I spent my time by the window I don't even know what I was doing as a kid. So quiet and so... I mean, we have this idea of kids being like super excited, jumping, want to play. I was like this... I'm usually more graceful. It's just not one of those days.
Right, but you enjoyed the attention.
I don't know if I enjoyed it. It was my first taste of, I don't know, any kind of recognition. So that made me want to sort of push myself into doing things that I'm not familiar with. I mean, what if I find something that I actually enjoy? So I stepped out. I wrote to my father a letter saying I want to move to a big city. It was like one of those letters jiska jawab hota hai question mark exclamation. You know, just like what? I really wanted to throw myself into a new environment, and I wanted to face the challenge because my life in Vizag was much more quiet. It was a quaint coastal town. Now it's a lot. There's a lot more hustle bustle, especially after the partition. But then it was because I was a school kid. So I think I moved to Bombay for college, only wanting that exposure, wanting to be amongst people who are so cool and hip and pop culture and this and that. And I came here, it was so difficult.
Was it?
It was a very hard time in Bombay for me to adjust, like emotionally. Also, I was very young. I was a 16-year-old kid who was inconfident and a little afraid. I didn't know Hindi. So I think it was a character building phase because I was constantly trying to...
So this is when you started taking those long walks?
Yeah, actually. Yeah. That's how, yeah. So, I mean, it started with taking random trains. And I sort of calmed down into long walks.
So here's a star who still takes an Uber.
Star is a bit weird, yeah. I don't know if I can get used to it.
Like, you still haven't gotten used to it?
Am I?
Matlab, guys, in the comments below, please.
Main tara hoon. Kya main star hoon?
So that was pretty hard for you.
Hard as in like it was new, and my parents, they don't speak Hindi. It was me and my younger sister, Samantha. We came to Bombay. She's in 9th standard. I'm in 1st year college, and I'm just like, I don't know Hindi. I'm like this outsider in a cool college, and I don't know. I was constantly struggling to belong, which is something I resonate with even in my character in the show. Yeah. Of course, her stakes are much higher, sure. But I used to take random trains, local train. I had a pass when I went to college, and I would take these trains and go like Mazgaon, the old docks, like random, just anywhere. Just sit in the train and get off, and sit at the station, drink one nimbu pani and go back. Now in retrospect, I'm like, what psycho behavior?
Yeah, very interesting. Because I must put it out there that I did request to do this interview in the more comfortable confines of your house. But you told me that it was a bat cave where you read and prepare and paint. I'm all the more fascinated about this space that you have for yourself. Just tell me more about it.
I've always been very introverted, like I was saying, as a child. But I think now I've become an outspoken introvert, where I'm able to sort of...
Chalo. I'm sure you're used to getting...
No, it's fine, yeah.
Yeah.
This security is a sadhu. He's not letting us sit here.
We'll find
just
another
keeping
random
it on belly. Camera. In case you want to use this. The reality of our time.
Ja rahe bhaiya, thank you though.
Thank you. Next.
Next. Moving on.
So, my house is a representation of me in a way. It's a simple studio apartment, 1 BHK, where I have like a lot of artwork and paints and crayons and too many books, too many chocolates. I don't really like other people because that's the last place that's absolutely mine alone. So that's where I can be absolutely naked, like a child, uncool, unfiltered. So it's like
so
a temple.
Private tea.
Yeah, and I prepare there, you know, acting, painting, reading, writing, music. So
you're big on painting?
It's a decent hobby. Yeah, but I've really, it's been very enjoyable. Like I feel a lot of release. Yeah.
When I did speak to you in that same conversation, you told me that the success of Made in Heaven hasn't set in, because the last I checked, you were still pruning plants and you had a pile of dishes to wash.
Yeah.
You should know that this is not stuff that I usually get told in interviews, which is why it's so refreshing. It's not stuff I hear stars talk about.
I don't even know if it's something I should share. I'm like, mujhe nahi bolna chahiye tha kya? I don't have any house help. Like, my father...
out of choice.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they want to work, people, of course. No, so as a kid, I was in NCC.
Right, okay.
So that, it made me want to be really self-sufficient and this strong person. We talk about feminism, we talk about so many things on social media, but how self-sufficient are we? How independent are we? Physically, emotionally, like I don't want to feel like I'm dependent on anyone. I want to take care of myself. I mean, of course, I'm not, if something goes wrong, I can't operate myself.
So you're doing the chores yourself?
Yeah, like jadu bhartan, pocha, laundry. But I enjoy it also, being able to provide for myself. That is living, no? It's not work. What else is life anyway? Providing for yourself and maybe to another. That's so...
So when you're ordering provisions, it's you opening the door and it's
ordering,
not weird?
Yeah, I go pick it up myself and all.
So, wow!
But it doesn't feel weird to me. So, like, your surprise comes as a surprise to me.
But what's the attention like? Do they stop you? Like, what's it like to suddenly have this super successful show and do have eyeballs on you and still go about your normal life?
I think I will truly be able to gauge the level of success when this translates into really good work opportunities.
Like, say,
I know that, okay, I get a few calls from actors or directors or producers texting or calling saying you've done a good job or, mm-hmm. you know, like congratulations.
Mm-hmm.
But that also feels very nominal. Itna to hota hai na, because they, of course, people have to acknowledge good work. Ideally, they should. So it's nice of them to congratulate me. But I think I will truly understand the scale of appreciation when I'm being hired more, because it's a direct
translation.
Yeah.
But how are you just generally assimilating this sudden barrage of attention, whether on your social media or, like you said, people reaching out and congratulating you? I'm sure there's a lot from the opposite sex as well. How are you assimilating all of that?
No, I don't mean to be like a killjoy, but it's been, it's possible that I've worked, you know, we see the, there's this quote, yeah, something like, we always see the highlight reel, we don't see the behind the scenes. So I know the amount of like strain I went through, as much physical as mentally. I'm 26 and I don't think I have the silliness, the light on my feet stride as a 26-year-old in another place would, because I've dealt with far, far more conflicts than they did. So I feel like in return, this feels fair. It doesn't feel like a reward, you know? I mean, I'm not saying I'm like some traumatized this thing, but I've had my share of ups and downs and learning, and it's been hard, especially because I've been alone.
Of course.
Yeah, I don't... My father's not an investor or a producer or a star. Mm-hmm. My parents are as much as an audience to my life as anybody else. So...
They haven't seen your show yet.
Yeah. Though there's a part of me that's like, maybe my mother saw it and she's just ignoring it because of the intimate scenes. I have a feeling, I'm not sure.
Right.
I'm going to meet her next week. We'll find out. I'll actually comment on this video, Niche, what happened of that.
Have you seen any changes in you in the past 1 month? Because that's a fair share of time to know what it feels like to belong to a really successful project. Have you changed at all?
No. In fact, I'm more me than I've ever been. You know, because it is, you want to see who someone really is, see what they are like when they're angry, see what they are like when they have power. That's who they are, not when they don't have anything.
Mm. Mm.
So I feel more closer to who I am. I have the freedom to be me. No actor, no artist wants to hustle. Figure out, yahan kya ho raha hai, wahan kya ho raha hai, audition ho raha hai,
acha acha.
Is there a part, this constant thing. So that sense of ease, even if for a bit, is very liberating. I can do my job. I can watch and learn and yeah,
breathe really. You talked about being a 26-year-old girl in this new city. I just want to know about your relationship with love. Is that something you seek or is it seeking you? Like you said, the attention has always been there from the boys.
No, I didn't say that.
No.
I've always been aware of my strengths and my shortcomings as a person. So I've been able to have a pragmatic approach to relationships. But also, I think love is a necessity and a luxury.
Do you see yourself dating an actor?
No? I can't even... Like, I think I'm more drawn to writers or people that have got to do with creating things out of thin air, out of nothingness. Like, a carpenter is closer to an actor. A sculptor is a creator, like, out of nothing. A carpenter hones his skill. It's like a craft. Also, I think I can't handle vanity. I can't, yeah. I just get very... I lose hope in life.
Look at you. We are sitting in a pile of almost rubble. Garbage.
Let's call it art.
Art. We'll find the art here. And of course, I had to ask, is there buzz of Made in Heaven 2?
I am... So contractually, we're all bound for 2 seasons. Two or more, something like that. So on contract, there is season 2. And I think they, even while we were shooting, they were talking about if we shoot, when we shoot season 2, we should do it in this place or this country.
How would you imagine season 2? You have a take? Because you write.
Oh, like that? No, I mean, I feel like there are certain aspects that can be explored more. Like Karan and Tara's friendship. How is she so non-judgmental?
Yeah.
Because she also comes from such a judgmental part of society.
Yeah.
That how is she so liberated from those?
Yeah.
That would be interesting. How she has the courage to be wrong, which is a lot of courage.
For sure.
So I would like to see her make more mistakes, but probably grander. Always makes for good drama.
Always grander. More power and more grandeur to you.
Thank you.
And everything that you have coming up. Listen, thank you for just being such a cool star. It is so refreshing to have someone who can just literally walk the streets with absolutely no air.
You know, hold on. We forget that we are actors, artists, storytellers, writers, singers, painters, whatever. It's like we get so caught up in the idea of being that, like, red carpet, this look, today's look. For it's just exhausting. Yeah? It's important to be. It's important to, like, observe. You know, otherwise, what a waste of life.
We have just been and observed and had a thoroughly refreshing conversation.
Thanks so much. Thank you so much.
Did you have fun?
I did. I have a feeling I've spilled too much tea walking the streets of Bandra with Sneha. It's called Spill the Tea with Sneha. It's on Film Companion. Subscribe. Watch. This is the first video.
Yes. Couldn't have asked for a better start. Thank you.